Okay, Star Wars fans, it's me, Darth Brewster, and I am back with another one just for you guys, and we have a brand new event for this Imperial Naval Assault. So, without further ado, let's get these jumpers going.
The space battle over Jakku started a year and 4 days after the Battle of Endor. Imperial Star Destroyers formed a defensive perimeter around...
We're going to enable those guys. We're going to enable those guys. And, of course, the jumpers. All right. Desert Jump Troopers performing.
First Order.
So I got my first research crate going right here. 3 minutes. Let it go one more time around on the...
So you got your big break as an actor a little bit later in life, which left plenty of room for some odd, offbeat jobs. When you were working as a forest firefighter, did you ever get a call that made you fear for your life?
Fire made me fear for my life. It was a terrible firefighter. I was soft as cotton candy and had no business being a forest firefighter. Actually, the very first call we ever got was a semi with a gas tank on fire.
Well,
he was pushing us closer to fire, and I was 3 feet away from the fire. On the foot of the CT, we were having a reverse tug of war on the hose, and it was bigger, and I won, and we ended up going very, very far away from the fire. And he tries to spray from 50 yards away. It was more like this. How many days do you do a week?
You know, we go weekly, so if we bang a bunch of episodes, then I'll have it chill a couple weeks. But if that gas tank runs low, then I have to just start stacking them. Like I did this yesterday.
I'm curious about There's when you are stacking. Let's get to the stacking.
It's really the cross that I bear. You know, it's the grave that I've dug for myself.
This is a girl's journey.
It really is. I appreciate you saying that. So the internet seems fascinated with philosophy, and then you've talked in the past about how sometimes the storylines of Modern Family can mirror your experience as a real-life father. So with that in mind, what I want to do is bounce some quotes off of you from other iconic TV dads. And I'm curious if you think it's good parenting advice or bad parenting advice. Well, let's see how it goes. This first one is from Homer Simpson counseling Lisa. If you don't like your job, you don't strike, you just go in every day and do it really half-assed. That's the American way.
it is the American way. I guess it's Homer Simpson. It has to be good advice.
This next one is from Uncle Phil on Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. To be a good friend, you have to risk losing a good friend.
I would agree with that, but I am so afraid of conflict that I don't know that I've ever challenged any of my good friends, so I don't know if I can live up to that, but I would agree with it in theory.
You don't necessarily have to be that person to dish out the good advice.
Yeah, right.
You know?
That's right. I like to do as I say and not as I do.
And then this last one is from Phil Duffy. The most amazing things that can happen to a human being will happen to you if you just lower your expectations.
I love that on many levels. Lowest expectation levels.
Where are your expectations today?
My expectation today is that it's going to hurt and tomorrow is going to be just... on the wrong side, take it.
The BX. So as we alluded to in your intro, you host a food-focused podcast, and then your wife, Holly, I know that she's a pastry chef.
Yep.
How, if at all, has she changed your perspective on food, because you've described yourself as a lawless animal when it comes to food?
We couldn't be any more different. The upside of having a palate of a goat is that everything she makes is great.
And then I know that you own a pair of bars in Salt Lake City. What was the biggest hurdle you had to overcome in securing a liquor license? Because from what I understand, there's some strange rules in Utah.
Yeah, well, they've actually gotten better. Back in the day, you had to do all kinds of crazy things. If you go all the way back, a drink couldn't be made in a bar, so they would actually give you, like, the airline bottle and the mixer.
And you do it yourself?
You do it yourself. Then they have memberships. You have to kind of become a member to get into a club, so everybody who walks into a bar has to become a member. That went away. It's very hard to get a liquor license. That, in and of itself, is very hard. Somebody smarter than me found a literal loophole, which is that if there's a hole in the wall or a doorway, the place next to you gets your liquor license. So we leased the space next to us and cut a hole in the wall.
And there you go.
And got a liquor license.
And then for the uninitiated, can you explain the allure of fry sauce?
Well, fry sauce is mayonnaise and ketchup, so that's all it is. It sounds a lot more exotic than it is. It's very good. It's really good. It is really good. Thank you. Do you have a hand in?
Yeah, we have the lab coats on. You know, it's like, do we go with the miso base? Do we go with the chipotle base? Do we go with the habanero base?
Okay, so I actually have a question about
sure.
this. My least favorite hot sauces are vinegar heavy.
I like the vinegar ones. I really do. I like the vinegar flavored hot sauces. I like all hot sauces, really. I got to get my meal out of there. No, I got it.
So it's one of those things where you can find it, where you can make it, but you kind of.
I can't start the research. Okay, that's all right. All right, like, share, and subscribe, guys. I'll see you guys next time. That's it. I'm done.